So we're just going to go straight into it. The first thing you're going to want to download is Resolve. I'll leave a link in the description on how to download it. Okay, so once you've opened up DaVinci Resolve, this is what it should look like. You're just going to want to go down to this edit tab at the bottom. I usually do all the editing here. If you're new to the DaVinci Resolve, I recommend learning all the basics to it, because this could be a bit advanced to go straight into speed ramping instead of not knowing how to trim and do sound audio edits and stuff. Because the first thing you're going to want to do is get in some clips. So, just obvious. I think it's in here. I'll just grab a random clip. Okay, so I found a few clips to import into here. To import them, you just go to your videos, choose something, and you can drag it and drop it. It's that easy. Then you're just going to want to go to YouTube and find yourself a nice song to edit with. Usually something with a beat is the best. Okay, so I'm just going to be using this song by Kina, Can We Kiss Forever. It just has a really good beat to it, and I could see a really good edit coming out of it. So you're just going to want to click share and copy the link. And then go to your Google search and search up MP3 juices. This is how you download MP3 music for your videos. And then you just want to paste it in this search bar in MP3 juices. Like that. And then click download. Now don't do anything on this tab. I'm pretty sure it'll get you a virus if you click download right here, so just do not do that. And it should be in the bottom left corner right here. So I usually just click this arrow and show in folder. Should be right here, and I just usually move it to my music. And then you're just going to drag and drop your MP3 file in here, just like you did with your videos. Okay, so you just want to drag your audio file down here. Put in a new audio track. And then your clip should be chilling here. You could just drag it in here as well, as same way you did that. And then I usually drag my clip over here and then find a nice song in the music to edit with. So like right here, it's just an intro. Maybe I'll skip up a bit. Maybe to this drop. Okay, sounds good. Now I'm just gonna grab this side of the track, drag it up here, trim it real quick. Maybe I'll get a bit longer, and then move my clip back here. Okay, so then you want to play your clip, see what it looks like, see if, yeah, I'm gonna want to trim that out because that was a mistake. If you don't know what I'm doing, how I'm doing this, just watch a video. Do a couple of montages and then come back and learn how to speed ramp. You're not ready if you don't know how to trim and stuff. Okay, so this is where my clip starts. I do like double side jump. Oh wait, single one. Yeah. Okay, it's looking good. Pretty basic free build. Alright, and then I want to trim it where I mess up. Okay, so I'm just going to find where I want the bass to drop at in the clip. So I think it'll look the coolest if I make a drop right here when I put down the two cones. Okay, so I'm just going to find where I want the bass to drop at in the clip. So I think it'll look the coolest if I make a drop right here when I put down the two cones. So what I'm going to do is put down a blue marker. It should mark it right here. I'm just going to zoom in a bit to make it easier. And then you're going to want to move the orange marker to where the base drops. So like right here. And then move these blue markers to the orange marker. And then as you can see, it should be playing on the when it base drops. Yeah. Looks good. Okay, so now to finally get to the slow-mo editing, you want to click on your clip, right-click it, and then you're going to click Retime Controls right here. Now this will pop up. Okay, so you're going to want to figure out where you want the slow-mo to be for the first time. So I'm going to start like right here. This is where my first slow-mo is going to be. So I'm going to click this little arrow here. Add a speed point, and it should add this little marker right here, this white marker. Here, this is where my first slow-mo is going to be. So I'm going to click this little arrow here, add a speed point, and it should add this little marker right here, this white marker. And then you're going to find where you want the slow-mo to end. So I just want to show that, and then speed up again. So I'll just add another marker right here. And then to change the clip speed, like the speed of that little part that you want slow, you click this little arrow between the two markers. And you can change the speed. Let's do 25%. So that'll make it slower now. Yeah. Now these blue markers I told you to put, they actually really did not help me at all, so you can delete those real quick. Sorry about that. Where I want the bass to drop. So like where I want it to be slow again. And then I'm gonna want it to end like right here. So I'll add another speed marker. And then zoom in if you can't see the black arrow between them. And then you could choose 25 or whatever speed you prefer. So it starts off normal speed and then it slows down right here on the side jump. Jump up, slows down again, right on the bass drop. And then I'm gonna add more slow-mo. So this is what we have so far. I'm gonna add more slow-mo to that. Do some more speed ramping. So I wanted to go slow-mo again here when I place the two cones. That'll look sick. So I'll just add another marker. And then I'm going to want it to end the slow-mo at like right here. So I'll add another marker. And then to get a better view at it, I can go like this. Zoom in a bit. Right here I can see the speed and just make it slower. That looks pretty good, I like that. So I actually want to speed it up in between these two slow-mos. So like, it just looks cooler, I think, in my opinion. So I'm going to speed up two times. Sometimes your clips will get really laggy with editing. So, to stop that from happening, You just want to click on the clip that you're editing. Only if it's really laggy and you have like frame drops when you're editing. You're going to want to right click on it, generate cache fusion output. Press on, go up here and click playback, and then render cache to user. So what's going to happen now is this blue line will slowly make get bigger and bigger across the entire clip. This will allow you to like edit more smoothly and it won't be choppy and frame drops and stuff. It's just really helpful. Make sure you do it. Now I really like how it looks without slow-mo after this. I just like having the fast edits in the rifle cone. And then maybe I'll add slow-mo right here on the triple edit. Oh, that was so clean. So always add a speed point where you want it to turn slow-mo. So right about here is good. Add speed point. And then where you want it to end. So maybe right here. And then click the black arrow in between them to make them slow-mo. You know what it is. Now that's a bit too slow for me, so I'm gonna put it up to 50%. Just make it go a bit faster. That looks good. Yeah, that looks good. So this is what we have on the first clip. Yeah, I really like that. That looks sick. Okay, and then to make it like more smooth, the transfer is like more smooth, you want to go right click on it and then go to retime curve, and then this will show up. So this is basically your slow-mo. So the steeper it is, the faster it is. So right here it's normal speed, slows down. Normal speed, slows down. Fast speed, slows down. Normal speed, slows down. Okay, to make it smooth, you want to click on the one that you want to make smooth, and then click this arched thingy. I have no idea what it is, but it's a thing. And then you want to grab these circles and stretch it out as far as you can to make it like really smooth. You'll really notice it. So I'm just gonna keep doing that on all of these. That one doesn't have them. Some of them don't have them when they're really close to each other. This one does. Yeah, just make them click on every single one and click this arc thingy and stretch it out. Now sometimes it will look better choppy, so like, I think one of these would look better choppy, like that one. This one will look better if it like goes fast into it. You might not understand what's going on, but as you get better you will. Now to close out all these slow-mo things, just go here, turn off retime curve, turn off retime controls, and then it looks like a normal clip. And now let's look at what we've got. I think that looks really sick. Alright, I'm gonna keep the video short. That's where I'm gonna stop it. If you need more in depth, just comment any questions. And if you didn't understand what was going on at all in this tutorial, just make sure to learn all the basics and then come back and watch a video and then see if you can do it. But everyone sucks at editing their first time, so just take it easy. And then you could get some good looking videos going. I'm still learning too. I'm pretty happy with this though. Damn, look at that. Damn. So that's how you use speed ramping in your videos. Hope this video really helped you out. Make sure you use code Waffleses in the shop and check out my other socials. And yeah, have a good day.